base 5 and base 2 convergent to base 10. So when you're dealing with base 2 and 5 and you're converging to base 10, and it doesn't really matter if you're dealing with base 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, as long as you're changing from one of those bases to base 10, the procedure or the process is the same thing. So there are four simple steps that you would have to do, and we are going to be going through those today. So this says change 343 base 5 to base 10. So you can have base 5 or the base written like this, or you can put it out in words to say something like this. Now this says 343 base 5 to base 10. So whatever base you are in and converting to base 10, you create that base table. So we are in base 5 and we are going to create a base 5 table. So you can always create your columns first. The first column always has the number 1. So every time you go to your left now, you multiply by whatever base you are in. So 1, we are in base 5. So 1 times 5 gives you 5. 5 times 5, 25. 25 times 5, 125. And you continue multiplying by 5 going upwards until you have sufficient space on your table to hold all the numbers given in your question. When you get your question now, your table, so this would be step 1. Step 2 would be filling in these digits. You generally start filling in from your right to your left. Reason being, you do not want to start from your left to right, and then when you're almost finished, you realize that you missed a place that would need a number or something like that. So 3, then 4, then 3. So that's step 2, filling in your digits. Step 3 now, whatever digits are in the same column, those should be multiplied together. So 3 and 25, 3 times 25, 5 times 4, 1 times 3 equals, so 3 times 25, that gives you 75. 5 times 4 gives you 20. And 1 times 3 is 3. Now, step 4 is the final step. Whatever your answers are for your multiplication process, or whatever the products are, you will add them together. So that's 75 plus 20 plus 3, and that is equal to 75 plus 20, that's 95, plus 3, that gives you 98. When you get your answer, you can either write out the word base 10, or you can put the 10 beneath it, and that would give the implied terms, or the explicit terms in math, that this is 98 base 10. So, for your answer, 3 base 5 is equal to 98 in base 10. The procedures now going with base 2 is the same thing. Step 1, so step 1, create your table. So we are in base 2 on this side, so you are going to create your base 2 table. So you would create your columns. Start at 1, so dealing with base 2, so 2 times 1 gives you 2. 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 2 is 8, 8 times 2 gives you 16. And you can continue on until enough places are there that can hold all the numbers. So step 1 is done. Step 2 now, putting the digits in on your table. So putting the digits, so 1 goes here, 0 is next, so you put a 0 there, 1 is here, and another 1 here. So that takes care of step 2. Now you're dealing with step 3, which is to multiply what's in the columns. So that's step 3. So that's 8 times 1, 4 times 1, 2 times 0, and 1 times 1 equals. 8 ones is 8, 4 ones is 4, 2 0 is 0, 1 times 1 is 1. And then now you reach a step 4, which is to add the products. So it's 8 plus 4 plus 0 plus 1. 8 plus 4 is 12. 12 plus 0 is still 12. And 12 plus 1 is 13. And you put your 10 at the bottom to show that it's base 10. So 1101 in base 2 is equivalent or equal to 13 in base 10. And that's all there is. And please remember, when you're dealing with bases, base 2 only has the digits of 1 and 0. Base 5 only has the digits of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Those are all the digits that are in base 5 or base 2 based on what you're dealing with. So thanks for watching, and I hope this video would have helped you to understand the concept of converting between bases 2 and 5 to base 10.